GM announced its first quarter earnings today, surprising many on the upside, driven largely by pickup truck sales, up about 27%. I talked to the GM chief financial officer, she's Dhivya Suryadevara, and I asked her about the critical question of when they can get their plants back up and running and whether they can replenish the inventories of those precious pickups.
Yeah, inventories are something that we're watching. We are well positioned on most car lines. And as you know, we came out of the strike in later part of last year, and we have had lower, leaner inventories. And it's frankly, it's going to be helpful in a scenario where SAR ramps up slowly looking at it. And from a pickup perspective, we do find ourselves in a situation where we have lower inventories. But the good news is the dealers have gotten very experienced in managing through the constraints that they're seeing in the product and how to dig deep into inventory and still maintain sales. So that's the good news. And as we think about the plans returning to work that we're targeting May 18th, that should help us address the shortfall from an inventory standpoint.
GM announced its first quarter earnings today. It also announced that it took out down some money from some revolving credit lines, something like $3 billion in the automotive, another $2 billion in GM Financial. That's after already amassing something like $33 billion in automotive liquidity. As you look forward, Dhivya, what tells you you're going to need that extra money?
So if you think about our liquidity, we've always, in the last several years, said we want to run a very strong investment-grade balance sheet. And that's actually come in handy during these kinds of times. And as you quoted, we did end the first quarter with a very strong liquidity position of $33.4 billion. And, David, it's difficult to anticipate what's going to happen, but we are taking steps to protect ourselves, whether it's austerity or, like you mentioned, revolver and suspending dividends and share repurchases as precautionary measures to make sure we have additional layers of liquidity. We are comfortable with our liquidity position now that will take us well into Q4, even in a scenario with which is pretty onerous of like zero production. And obviously, as we talked about the restart, when we have a restart, the levels, our liquidity levels will recover from here. So I would say these actions are precautionary and proactive actions to make sure we have additional liquidity buffers in place. So what we're focused on now is to safely restart the plants and get the production up and running.
So this pandemic comes along at a time when the auto industry and General Motors were going through a transformation, a fundamental one, to autonomous and electric vehicles. You've been investing quite a bit in both of those. Are you changing your investment plan on that? Do you have to put that to the side while you deal with the after effects of the pandemic?
Absolutely not. We are marching ahead in our plans with EVs and AVs. We're committed to an all-electric future, and all the plans that we've outlined recently in our Capital Markets Day, as well as our EV Day, with respect to the products, the exciting products that are going to be rolling out, we see little to no impact on any of these. The capital actions we're taking and the austerity actions will not impact the programs that that you just outlined. So we're fully committed to that. And frankly, the balance sheet that we've been maintaining and the financial flexibility we have allows us to continue these investments as we go forward, even in these challenging times.
Dhivya, you raised one last issue, which is the pace of the introduction of new vehicles. Put aside EVs and AVs, just in general, that's one thing that's been a hallmark of CEO Mary Barra while she's been there, having an increased pace of new vehicles. Is that going to slow down?
We are committed to putting products that our customers are very excited about, and you can see the success that we've had recently even with our trucks, and that's not going to change. And we do put the customer in the center of everything we do, and you will see that continue in the product cadence that comes along here.